my name is Ann Saunders, and we are in the Kilgus Research Building, which is the Research Center for Women and Infants Hospital. My research is looking at early placental development and how different cell types develop, and we're using this to help us understand pregnancy-related diseases such as preeclampsia. Most of my family is from Grenada. I used to go every summer when I was a kid. I'm on a dance team. Yeah, I'm like the only grad student with a group of undergrads, but I used to dance from the age of 3. My dad was a math teacher, and my mom taught, I think she taught multiple subjects. She taught at a convent, so. I was always pretty good at science, but I just kind of really enjoyed science. I've always really enjoyed science. Since I was a kid, really. Like, when we used to have science fairs, I always wanted to do an extra science fair project because one was not enough. Pre-eclampsia is basically a disease that happens late in pregnancy. Mostly what I work with is collecting placental tissues and comparing the expression levels of different genes.
What we see here is obviously a green sample, looks like a fractured tibia, something around day 7, and sample number N496, slide number 77, it is one series of 7.
Pretty good.
Yeah, thank you.
And hopefully the more we understand about what goes right, the more we can understand when things go wrong. I think that sometimes it's great to have someone who's as excited about what you're learning as you are. We have fun. In undergrad, I was pre-med and I was planning to go to medical school. I guess when you're younger, I feel like I just thought medical school was like the only thing you did when you liked science. That makes sense. And then I started doing research the second semester of my junior year and thought, oh, this is something else I can do with a science degree. And I really enjoyed it. When I started doing research, I felt that it just fit me better. You know, you're still helping people in a way, but it's not necessarily the same, and you kind of have a little bit more freedom. So when I applied to grad school, I was definitely interested in development because I think that, I just think that that's what's most interesting and that's what's really important. Like, understanding how early development happens and what's going on, that's important to having a healthy adult. I think that as a doctor, that if you're a doctor who's not doing research, that you have a set of tools that you can work with to help people, whereas in research I feel like I'm like helping make the tools that and improving the tools that people work with to help people. So I feel that I'm still, you know, helping and contributing to the greater good, but it's just a different way. My parents encouraged me to go to medical school. When I was really young, I was like, I want to be a teacher, and they're like, you don't want to be a teacher. You should go to medical school or something like that. And I did want to go to medical school, but they were like, you don't want to be a teacher. I think it's a cultural thing, you know? I feel, especially a lot of students or a lot of people who are like the first generation born in the U.S., a lot of their parents feel that careers like medicine or law are more like stable and they'll probably pay you better. When I first decided I didn't want to go to medical school, my mom said, but why not? But they love it now. They love, because they can tell that I'm enjoying what I'm doing. So I actually really want to teach. So after graduation, I would love to get a position that will allow me to do some teaching as well as research. Maybe today it's not going to be, you know, that plate that I just that I just pipetted, but maybe like 10 years from now it might be whatever I just did, or maybe, you know, 5 years from now it might be whatever I just did that's going to help someone else come up with some other, you know, medical achievement.
Thank you.